Welcome to the Rick Helps Real Estate Show, where we look at the numbers and try to figure out what's going on in this market. And there was talk of a market shift, so let's take a look and see if that's happening. Now, Friday, it's supposed to be 63 degrees here. We're getting away from that sweltering 80-degree heat. But here's what's fun. You'll be able to tell who's from here and who's not from here on Friday just by looking. The people from Michigan are still going to be wearing shorts and flip-flops, and the locals in Arizona, I kid you not, are going to have stocking caps on and down jackets. They start freezing to death. I used to sit in the Starbucks with a buddy of mine, and we'd look out the window and play from here, not from here. We'd go Michigan, Phoenix. So it's going to get cold. 63 is not cold, but a low of 41, that's a little chilly. So what's going on? We have 7,120 listings this morning. We're starting to get some more coming back on. As you can see here in the 7-day moving average, we are mirroring last year. Here's Thanksgiving right there, right? So the yellow line is the number of homes that are under contract, and the blue line is inventory. So they had a big gap here, just like they did here, and now they're starting to come back up. We're going to see, you can see it starting here and starting there, where both lines are turning again back down as we get ready for Christmas in a couple of weeks. So this is a seasonal dip, not really anything that we can change. December is going to be extremely low inventory, and we're just holding our breath for January. It's hard to tell. We're like tracking right on to 2020 numbers, and 2020 was a year that you just really couldn't follow because it was so disrupted, but yet here we go, right there following 2020 numbers. So the Federal Reserve, here's the first shift you should know about. It says comments by Fed officials suggest the central bank is likely to double the pace of its taper to $30 billion a month at its December meeting next week. Initial discussions could also begin as soon as December meeting about when to raise interest rates and by how much next year with Fed officials when they're set to submit a fresh round of economic forecasts and projections. So that's going to happen, I believe, on the 10th. So there's no consensus yet on when to begin the hikes, but it's clear that the faster taper is designed to give the Fed flexibility to raise rates as soon as the spring. But here's the kicker. The markets do not appear to expect the first rate hike until this summer. So again, the Fed says they're going to do this, and the markets are going, we think you're probably going to wait longer than spring. So this may be one of the reasons that we're starting to see the Cromford Market Index go up a little bit again. In other words, it's in favor of sellers. I think there's buyers out there and institutional buyers. They deal mainly in cash, but buyers are afraid that interest rates are going to get out of control, and they're trying to get out and get locked in now. And yet there's some data that shows that mortgage applications are down on Q3 and Q4. The last quarter of 2020 and the first quarter of 2021. I'm getting those numbers screwed up. Anyway, mortgage applications are down about 6%. So not showing up in the numbers yet, but here's where we're at in the Cromford Market Index. And again, I just mentioned we're following 2020. Here we go. Just doing the same thing. It's going to go up because we're going to have less homes for sale. And then in December, January, it should start coming back down, but it didn't last year. See? So whereas in 2019, it took a slight dip. Let's see what happened in 2018. Just kind of stayed flat right here. Remember, 100 is considered a balanced market, and we're sitting up here at 360. So until that number changes, prices will go up about 2% a month. There's no avoiding it while we're in this situation. Here's our active listings. They actually took a little tick up this past week, to an average of 6,500, about ready to cross 2020 levels. But as we saw on the 7-day moving average, they're going to start turning down yet again. This shows our sales month data to date. So it's kind of a bit of an eye chart, but really when you look at it, this far right-hand column here is November 21. The next one over here is November 20. Then it goes 19, 18, 17, so you can see that in 2021 that sales are way up. And these are sales by month, just comparing November. So these two columns here are far larger than anything you've seen all the way back to 2008. This is when everything fell off the map. So we're looking and saying, well, it's starting to cool a little bit. Yeah, 200 homes. You know, that's not, you're not walking into a refrigerator there, so it's not getting too cool. So it is slightly down, but I think it's down because listings are down. We don't have enough homes to buy, so it's hard for sales to catch up, except in the luxury market. Luxury market seems to be doing extremely well this month, but even they have a bit of a shortage. You look at Fountain Hills, and they're going nuts. So going nuts by not having very many homes for sale. The other thing I like to look at that I've been showing you is the closings per month above list price. This has a little bit of encouragement in it, although it's hard to find in certain price points. It's showing here that 42% of the homes are still going above list price. And where the beatdown is in the 300 to 400 range and the 400 to 500 range. You got 54% of the people in the 300 to 400. Those homes are going above list. And 400 to 500, 46%. And the encouraging part is they're only going about 10,000 above list price. But it really, in reality, it means that when you're going and putting an offer on a home, instead of competing with 12 other offers, you probably competing with three or four. So that doesn't help you. There's still amazing bidding wars. Interesting one this weekend. This home was listed for $489, and nobody was writing offers for it. They reduced the price by $20,000 down to $469, and then it got bid up to $480. Now, when it was $489, why didn't anybody swoop in and offer them $480? Because they took it. But that's the psychology of pricing. If you see a home that's been on the market and you think it's overpriced, write a lower offer. It's interesting, though, when they drop it $20,000, they get it down there and it gets all this attention. Everybody scurries and tries to get that home, and they bid it right back up to the price it was last week. It's really hard to figure. I thought for sure we were going to get this home. When we wrote this offer, we had already found out that they had an offer that was below list, and we put ours in. And then I woke up in the morning, and lo and behold, I had an email, Rick. Sorry to say that they decided to go with another offer. Very frustrating. And I know it's been the year of the buyer beatdown, and it continues. And let's just hope that January we start seeing some more listings, because we are seeing some surveys out there that said something like 36% of homeowners said that they're considering listing their home this winter. So let's see what happens. Here's an interesting thing I bumped into this morning. It's a mortgage company, and it's called, better.com. They had a Zoom call, and the only people that were invited on a Zoom call were the people that were going to get fired. They laid off 700 people, I think it was. So just days after receiving a $750 million cash infusion, a tech startup that Forbes branded in October as a unicorn, valued at $7 billion, laid off hundreds of employees in a manner that some online deemed brutal. They did it on a Zoom call. It's a digital mortgaging lender with offices in Oakland. They laid off 900 employees weeks before Christmas on a mass Zoom call. Only those being laid off were invited. It's a stark title shift to the company, which announced it was going public early this year. Could you imagine that? Getting a, all right, guys, hey, we want to have a Zoom call here. And you don't see who else is invited. You know, sometimes when people send out an invitation on an email, you can see, why didn't they invite Jim? So you're on this Zoom call and you're sitting there with your cup of coffee and you're making sure you look good on camera and you get fired. This work at home thing has really changed some cultures. I just think that's repugnant. Wow. Best of luck to you guys. The mortgage industry is still going strong, so go work somewhere else. That's a digital one. Maybe you can call Quicken and tell them, hey, I'm available, because they're hiring. So hopefully none of you are going to fire your employees on a Zoom call. But in the meantime, I hope you push this like button here, because you like not being fired on a Zoom call. And I will see you tomorrow. Take on the day.